morning. It's another Wesley Wednesday with Pastor Dave. Over the past few months, we have visited some of the historic Wesley sites in the U.S. and in England. I hope you have enjoyed hearing about these places and have learned a little more about our United Methodist heritage. One of my goals in retirement is to be a lifelong learner. Preparing these Wesley Wednesday devotions each week has definitely been a learning experience. Even though I have participated in several Wesley heritage tours and visited most of these sites, I felt the need to further research each place. Most weeks, I have spent at least 2 hours visiting websites, reviewing site booklets, looking at photos and notes from my trip. I think I'm now qualified as an official tour guide. My biggest challenge, however, was compiling all of this information into a short 4-minute devotion. Deacon Andrew and I are discussing the possibilities of my leading a small group on our Wesley heritage in the future. Let us know if you might be interested. I'm also considering putting together another Wesley heritage trip to UK, and again, let us know if you might be interested. In the meantime, I encourage you to visit the websites of these places that we have visited. Most of them provide an excellent virtual tour of their site. And now for a quick summary of our travels here in the U.S. Our first few stops were in Georgia to reflect on John and Charles's missionary work in the colonies. We visited St. Simon's Island, Fort Frederica, and Savannah. Here we learned of the trials of the Wesley brothers and how they returned home with deep questions about their personal faith. John developed a friendship with Moravian Christians on this trip, which would prove to be instrumental in his faith development. I then took us on a quick review of the beginnings of the Methodist denomination here in America. We visited historic churches in Delaware, Philadelphia, and Baltimore. Each place had a significant role leading up to the Christmas Conference of 1784 and the establishment of the Methodist Episcopal Church in America. Along the way, I introduced you to Bishop Francis Asbury, who was the driving force of the growth of Methodism in America. You also learned about Richard Allen, the first bishop of the African Methodist Episcopal Church, or AME Church. We made stops along the way at two of my favorite places for spiritual growth, Lake Junaluska Assembly in North Carolina, and Epworth-by-the-Sea on St. Simon's Island, Georgia. Now, I find it interesting that although the Wesley brothers were only in America for a short time, they had a powerful influence on the spiritual awakening in our country. In the coming year, once we are free from COVID, I would love to organize a trip to Georgia so that we can visit in person some of these places. Next week, I will give an overview of the sites we visited in the UK. Thanks for listening, and I'll be back next Wednesday. Have a blessed day.